everyone. My name is Lauren Walters. I am a graduate student who lives here in Evanston, and I go to Northwestern University. And I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about my story and how I got there and how my journey kind of was all about connecting the dots along the way. I grew up in Seattle with my family. We did a lot of biking, a lot of sports. My brother and I even had a mouse when we were growing up. But one of the uniting things that I always remember is that I loved learning and I loved reading, even if I might not have been quite as interested in science when I was really young. I did softball and I even ran track in high school. After graduating, I had decided to go to college, and when thinking about what I wanted to study, I thought that I did want to study science. And one of the things that drew me to science was my love of small things, so bear with me. Using a microscope, I don't know if any of you have ever done that, but it's really cool to try and be able to look at things that we can't normally see with our own eyes. There are a lot of different things that scientists study that are really small and we need a microscope to look at. One such thing is cells, and these make up our entire human body. They make up animals and they make up plants. Another are viruses and proteins. I'm sure we have all been thinking about coronavirus a lot in the last little bit, and that's exactly what it is, a virus. But both of those I wasn't quite as interested in. I've always thought that the more basic building blocks of our world, atoms, are actually really fascinating. Atoms make up cells, they make up viruses, but they also make up the road, pencils, anything that we use. And my thought, when I was choosing my major was, why don't I study the very basics of what our world is built on? I mean, what's more cool than that? So even though I said I wanted to work with atoms, my first job was actually in a bio lab, as you can see here. But I eventually ended up moving into a computational lab when a new professor to our university decided to take a chance on me as an undergraduate and hire me into his lab. And it was one of the best experiences I could have asked for. So one of the first things I learned to do in my lab was to code, which I was very intimidated about. From all the movies, I assumed that I would be hacking into government databases and should already know how to do it before I had been taught. But thankfully, I was able to push through that. I had a really amazing mentor and a really amazing professor looking out for me. And slowly but surely, I learned how to use a lot of the code that scientists use to study and create and understand new materials. Now, my research focuses on atoms, and like I said, atoms are super exciting things. They're basically the building blocks of everything that we see around us. And atoms, just like building blocks, come in a lot of different shapes, sizes, varieties, and I'm sure you've heard a lot of them. Gold is an atom. Now, atoms are building blocks, like I said, but they're also very, very small, and so therefore we need a lot of them in order to be able to see the things around us and to be able to see ourselves. We can combine atoms together by making bonds in between them, and that's what you're seeing here. Now, when a lot of bonds form between atoms, they can form materials that we see all around us. What I'm showing here, I don't know if any of you can recognize it, but it's actually graphene layers. And graphene layers form graphite, and graphite can form a lot of different materials, including pencil lead, which you guys, I'm sure, have on your desks right now. And if we think about the ways that different atoms can arrange, I'll show you a picture here of rust. And so the gold atoms that you see, these gold dots, those are actually iron. And then the red is oxygen. And this is actually what happens on a really, really small level anytime you see rust forming on the outside of something that's made of iron. And next, we see water, which is something that I'm sure that you guys have all had a drink of today. And so this is actually what water looks like when it's in its molecular form, when you zoom down to the smallest scale that you can for water. And it's really exciting to see that you can see the red is the oxygen, the pink is the hydrogen, and when there are enough of these tiny little groups together, we get the water that we know and love. So my job as a graduate student is to perform research. And what that basically means is that I try and do new science. I try and discover things that no one has discovered before, which is so exciting. And one of my projects that I've done that I'm pretty proud of, honestly, is finding this new material that goes from electrically conducting, which means that it has electricity go through it, like a light bulb or like a wire, or even like the electricity in your phone, and it goes from being electrically conducting to insulating. And so that's kind of like the outside of a wire. So wires are coated with rubber so that you don't get shocked by the electricity going through it. And it's the same thing. So this material can do both. It can be electrically conducting and electrically insulating. And I was part of the team of researchers at Northwestern that actually discovered this material. And we did this with computational materials, with coding, and we were able to actually look at a bunch of different ways that we could arrange atoms, which we have just been talking about, and trying to understand how if we arrange the same atoms but in a different way, how we might be able to have this switch from being able to conduct electricity to being able to insulate and stop the electricity from flowing through the material. And so what I'm showing here is the fact that we tried a bunch of different combinations of these atoms and these building blocks, 85 actually, and we did a bunch of coding and analysis with them, and we're able to find these two structures. So the alpha and beta, I realize they look very similar, but the red is basically oxygen. The purple atom that you see in the middle of these shapes is called molybdenum, and then the blue on the bottom is a nitrogen atom. And so when you arrange, this is on the molecular scale, but when you arrange these atoms in this way, in one of these phases, so one of these ways to arrange the atoms, you actually, again, conduct electricity, and then in the other, with slight variations on how you stack the atoms, you're allowed to make it conductive. And so what I'm just showing right here now is when we move the atoms a little bit, we can actually change and build in these different properties. So we can build in electrically conducting materials. We can build in the fact that materials can actually be insulating, which is so, so cool to be able to change. And it's something that's been really exciting to look at. And we're trying to understand and discover more different materials in the future. I love being a grad student. I get to work on problems that I find are creative and interesting and that are going to be impactful in this world. But one thing I want to emphasize in my journey was that even if it seems like it was linear, it really wasn't. I held myself back from a lot of opportunities I really should have seized in the beginning in college because I didn't really feel I was good enough. And so one piece of advice I'd like to give to you all, because I wish someone had given it to me, is to pursue what you want to pursue and to work hard at it and to not be your own worst enemy, because that's what I was to me. I held myself back personally from trying to learn how to code because I just didn't think I was good enough. So I just want to tell you all to pursue your dreams and don't hold yourself back because you are good enough. So thanks for listening. I wish you all the best with your journeys and your academic goals and your life goals. And it's been great meeting you. Bye.